Assalamu alaikum, dear students. I hope you all are fine. I'm your English teacher from IYS school. Our topic for today's class is our unit number 4, grammar, vocabulary and spelling of both books, course book and workbook. You all know very well that yesterday I explained you unit number 4. I gave you the meaning of difficult words. Then I showed you question answers, and then I gave you the home task. I hope you all had done your home task in your shared copies. Now please open your course books, page number 48 of your course book. Please open page number 48 of your course book, and before starting our task, I am giving you some instructions. Please follow my instructions. Okay, don't interrupt me during the class. Once the class will end, you will be free to ask question and query. Please ask your question in the chat box and I will answer you through audio. Have a pencil in your hand and both of your book, Active English Course Book and Active English Workbook 4, with you. Today is our book work, so you have to keep a book and kept a book and a workbook, course book and a pencil with you, so it will easy to solve the exercises with me. Okay students, now I'm starting the class, and open page number 48 of your course book. First of all, we will do the exercises and present on our course book. Then we will move towards the workbook. So open page number 48 of your workbook, course book. So there's a vocabulary related to the unit number 4. The vocabulary is suffix. So the definition of suffix is: a suffix is a group of letters that is added to the end of a word to form a new word. So, why we use suffix? What is the need? Why we use suffix in English grammar? We use suffix to form a new word. We add suffix at the end of the letter. Okay, at the end of the letter means at the end of the letter or a word, when we add a suffix, it will become a new word. Okay, students, have you got my point that if we add a suffix at the end of the word, it will become a new word. So, why we use suffixes? What is the use of suffix? The use of suffix is that to form a new word by adding a word at the end of the word. So we get a new word. Okay, the suffix word mean in the direction of. So today we are going to study the suffix word. We are going to study the suffix word. Word is the word which is placed at the end of every word. If you place suffix word at the end of the every word, it will become the new word. Like examples, backward. Back is a word, na? Back is a word. When we add suffix word with it, you see, when we add suffix word with it, it becomes a new word, backward. Okay, which is the meaning of very words and backward type of things. Okay, straightforward is a word. When we add word at the end of straightforward, it become straightforward, which means up to right, means straightforward, up to right person. So it becomes a new word. Forward, for is a word. We place word at the end of the for, so it becomes a new word. Similarly, unto word. Unto word mean, unto is a word, and word, when we add word at the end of the unto, it becomes unto word. Reward. Re means to do something again. Vard is a word which is a suffix. We add vard at the end of the re, so it becomes rivardmin. Some a price, a rebag of something. Awkward. Awk is a word, we add word with it, so it becomes awkward. To explain you more, I had this screen, this chart for you. The suffix word means in a certain direction. Suffix word, why, when we use suffix word, why we need to use suffix word? We use suffixes to form a new word, and why we use suffix word? Suffix word mean in a direction of, in a direction of, when we want to show a direction of a thing, we use suffix word. When we show the direction of something, we add suffix word at the end of the specific word. Okay, student, like example, there was nothing separating him from the edge of the cliff and a plunge downward. Downward mean it is denoting toward a direction that it is the down. Down is the base word, and when we add suffix, word is the suffix, and it means in a direction. Therefore, downwards mean moving down. Okay, I hope you understand it very clearly now. What is the use of suffix? Why we use suffix? We use suffix to place them at the end of a word to form a new word, to make a new word. And why we use suffix word? Suffix word is used to show the direction, to denote the direction of the word. Okay, students, now come to page number 48 of your course book. Here is the exercise of the vocabulary. So we have to done it in your, you have to done it in your, do it in your course book. I will demonstrate to you, and you have to complete it by your own. Okay, I am reading here. I am explaining you here. I am dictating you here. So keep your pencils in your hand and fill these blanks with me. Okay. Blank number one is, we need to add a little fertilizer to dash the growth of the plants in the terrarium. To forward. Forward means to begin. We need to add a little fertilizer to dash the growth of the plants in the terrarium. Means we need to add the fertilizer to begin. Forward means begin, to start the growth of plants in the terrarium. So which suffix will go here? Forward. Okay. Now, blank number two. My 4-year-old niece can count from 50. My 4-year-old niece can count backward from 50. So here in this blank, suffix backward is added. Okay, we add backward here because you here you are explaining that your niece can count backward from 50. Okay, blank number three, making a terrarium should be a simple, straightforward process. Straightforward mean simple and up to right process. Straightforward. In third blank, it we use word straightforward. We use suffix straightforward. Blank number four, dash conditions such as lack of water and extreme heat will kill the plants in the terrarium. So untoward. Untoward means the condition which are not favorable. The conditions which are not favorable. Untoward conditions such as lack of water and extreme heat will kill the plants in the terrarium. Okay. Now, blank number five. Jennifer was a dash dancer when she first started learning ballet. Okay, Jennifer was an awkward dancer. Awkward dancer means something which is not very good, something which is awful. Okay, something which is not very remarkable. Okay, so you are denoting the direction of Jennifer that he was not a very good dancer. Mean he was an awkward dancer. Blank number 5, awkward. Okay, blank number 6. Our best dash for making a terrarium was to see grandma's smile when she saw her very own indoor garden. So what is the blank of what is the will come in the blank number 6? Reward. Our best reward for making a terrarium was to see grandma's smile when she saw her very own indoor garden. Okay, students, I hope you have completed this exercise with me. Come to page number 49 of your course book. Here, giving you the grammar of the unit number 4. They are explaining you relative clause. Okay, the relative clause, what are the meaning of relative clause? A relative clause tells us more about the person. Relative clauses are the clauses which tell us more about the person. Okay, person, animal, or thing in the main clause. Okay, so you all know very well relative mean to show relation with something. Okay, so relative clauses are those clauses which tell us more about person, animal, or things. Okay, in the main clause there are two type of clauses in the sentences. One is main clause and other is subjective clause. So you relative clauses are those clauses which tell us more about the main clauses. Okay, relative clauses about animal or thing begin with that or which, means in which we are showing relation of animals or thing, we use relative clause that or which. So that or which is used with the animal or things. Okay, relative clause about people begin with that. We strictly use that relative clause. Relative clause that with the peoples. Okay, so I'm repeating again. We use that and which for animals and things. Okay, and we strictly use relative clause that to show the relation of main clause with the people. When we are talking about people and when we want to show the relation of people, we use the relative clause that. Okay, so for example, the colorful token which Matthew followed led him to forest. Okay, means the colorful token which Matthew followed. So the colorful token has a relation with Matthew. Matthew is a person, name of person. So we use which. Okay, we show the relation of token with the Matthew. So we use which, because token is a non-living thing. Okay, token is a thing. The terrarium which is in my room was made by the children. Okay, the terrarium is a thing. So we show the relation of terrarium with the children. So which is used when we are showing the relation of terrarium with the children's relation of a thing. So we use which. The cat that purred loudly was Amelia's pet. Okay, now we are showing the relation of cat with the Amelia's. Amelia is the name of a person. So we use relative clause that, because Emily is a person. So when we want to show the relation of a person with the something, we use relative clause that. The earthquake that struck Japan killed many people. Okay, the earthquake that struck Japan killed many people. Now we are showing relation of a people to the earthquake, so we have to add that in it. Okay, the children that go to this school are polite and well behaved. Okay, means now you are showing the relation of a children with the school. So children are a living thing, children are the persons, okay, peoples. So we add relative clause that. Okay students, now have your pencils in your hand and match these columns with me. Okay, match the statements with their relative clauses. Okay, the parent has that swim in the Amazon River are deadly. In the next row, third line, third dot, you have to match first dot with the third dot of the second row. The parent has that swim in the Amazon River are deadly. Join them like this. Okay, plants which are left in the dark often die too soon. Means plants which are left in the dark often die too soon. If you are showing the relation of the plant with the dark room, so plants are thing, so you have to add which here. The cat that made the mess was a stray. The cat that made a mess is a stray, so you have to join it with the here. The storybook which I ordered 2 weeks ago arrived yesterday. Okay, you are showing your relation with the storybook, so you use which with that. Okay, join them like this. The girls that performed in a play are Alex's sister. Now you are showing the relation of a person with another person, so you are putting here that relative clause. Okay, the people that live in the island are very helpful. Now you are showing the relation of the people of the people with the island and their behavior. You are talking about the behavior of the people, so you have to put here that relative clause. Understand student? I hope you have done it with me. Okay, I am moving towards the next page. Now here we have read about the relative clause that and which. Okay, where we use that? We use that with the animals and things. We use that and which with the animals and things, and we use that only. We only use that with the people to show the relation with the peoples and to show the relation with the animals or with the things. We use that or which. Now we are moving towards the relative clause who and whom. Where we use whom and where we use whom. We discuss the uses of who and whom. Relative clauses about people also begin with who and whom. Relative clauses about people. Now they are adding more. In previous page, we read about the relative clauses that. We only use that with the people to show the relation with the people. But here they are also telling you that we use who and whom with the people. Like you see here, relative clauses who. Who is a kind of a relative clause. We use when the subject or object we want to describe is a human. Means we use who relative clause with the persons. We use it with the human beings. Relative clauses provide detail about the action specified in the preceding clause. Okay, if you wish, we can examine this in more detail through an example. Like the woman who is with the red dress asking me the address was very beautiful. Now you are talking about a human, a woman. So you all know very well that women are human, is a human being. So we use relative clause who. The teacher who came to Spain in 2001 likes to ride her mountain bike. You are talking about your teacher. Teacher is a human being. So you have to add here who. I think the people who that live on the island are very friendly. Okay, now you are talking about the people. So peoples are human beings. In short, we use relative clause who with the human being. We use it with the human being. Okay. We use who as an object or subject pronoun and whom as an object pronoun. We use who in object or subject. You all know very well, subject is a person who is doing something, an object on which subject doing work. Okay, so in the subject and object we use who, and in the object pronoun we use whom. Understand, student? Now these are the examples present in your course book. I told you about the girl who lost her shoes at the beach. Now you are talking about a girl and it is the subject pronoun. So girl is a subject pronoun, so you have to add who here. Okay, you are relating a girl with the shoes. Okay, so girl is a human being, you have to add who with the girl. Mr. Thompson, who live across the road, always leaves for work at 5 in the morning. Now you are talking about Mr. Thompson. Okay, you are talking about subject pronoun. Okay, so you have to use who here. I was invited to dinner by the lady whom I met at the wedding last month. Now here is the object pronoun. You are invited by someone. Okay, so you have to use whom here. You are showing the relation with the lady whom. You have to use whom because the lady who is invited you is an object pronoun. The students whom the principal told off sternly did not dare to be late again. Okay, the students whom the principal told off sternly did not dare to be late again. Now you are talking about students and the principal, so you have to use whom because principal had issued them. Principal is an object pronoun, so you have to put whom here. Okay, now have your pencils in your hand and complete this exercise with me. Combine the two sentences using our relative clause. Begin each relative clause with who and whom. Now you have to add who and whom in these are like two sentences. You all know very well when we put a full stop at the end of the sentence, it will become a one sentence. It means the sentence is completed. So you have to show make a relative clause. You have to use the clause here to show the relation of these two sentences. Now you have to rewrite these sentences in the given area in your books. So Rose is a doctor who lives in the New York. You have to replace she with the who. Okay, you have to replace the pronoun she with the who. Rose is a doctor who lives in the New York. Black number two. I love my grandma dearly. She passed away recently. Okay. I love my grandma dearly, whom passed away recently. Now, grandma is an object pronoun. So, you have to put whom here. Replace the she with the whom. Okay. And rewrite this sentence. Carla is a Sam's daughter. She is a teacher. Okay, Carla is a Sam's daughter who is a teacher. Now replace the she with the relative clause who, and rewrite this sentence again. I met Danny at the dance class. He invited me for lunch. Okay, now you have to put here a relative clause like I met Danny at the dance class. You are explaining that you met Danny at the dance class. He invited me for lunch. Okay, now you are saying that you are invited him at the lunch. Who invited me for lunch? So replace he with the relative clause who. These men work at the chocolate factory. They are very hard working. Now you have to relate these sentences with each other. So we add relative clause who. The men work at the chocolate factory who are very hard working. You are talking about a man and there is no objective pronoun here. So you have to put who here. I saw a girl at the library. She was Tiffany. I saw a girl at the library who was Tiffany. Tiffany is the name of the girl. Okay, whom. Whom is replaced. You can replace the word she with the relative clause who. Understand, students? Now, I am moving towards the next page, which is of spellings. Open page number 51 of your course books. Open page number 51 of your course book. Read the words with the long vowel IH sound. These are the spelling words which have long vowel IGH sound. IGH sound, long vowel words. Mean when you read these words, it will give you the sound of long vowel IGH. Okay? Light, sight, flight, right, highlight, might, sig, high, bright, slight, mighty, fright, height, delight, and thigh. These all are your long vowel IGH sound words. I am repeating again. When I read this sentence, please concentrate on the sound of these words. It gives you the long vowel IGH sound. Light, sight, flight, right, highlight, might, sig, high, bright, slight, mighty, fright, height, delight, and thigh. Now you have to fill the blanks with these words given at the top of your page. These are the words you have to use them in to fill these blanks. Please dash the problem to the restaurant manager. I'm sure he will have a good talk with the waiter about his bad attitude. So please highlight the problem to the restaurant. The word highlight will go here. Okay. Number two. There was a dash increase in fuel prices. Means you have to add slight. There is a slight increase in your petrol prices. The word slight goes in the second blank. Third blank, it was with great delight that we presented the terrarium to our teacher as a Teacher's Day present. Okay, the word delight will go in the blank number three. Blank number four, she suffered a cut on her dash when she fell from her bicycle. So, she suffered a cut on her thigh. Okay, thigh. Thigh will go in the blank number four. Number five, plants need air, water, and dash to grow light. So, plants need air, water, and light. Light is the word which go in the blank number fifth. Blank number 6. You gave me a dash when you crept up on me like that. Means you give me a fright. Fright is the word which go in the blank number 6. Adam tried with all his dash but could not move the heavy cupboard. Okay, students? Adam tried with all his might but could not move the heavy cupboard. Now, this is the end of your exercises. Now, I'm going to show you home task. This is your home task, students. Complete all exercises of course book in your books. Only complete the exercises of course book, okay? Means you have to complete page number 48, 49, 50 and 51 in your course book. Don't touch your workbook, okay? We will do the work of workbook in your next class, in your tomorrow's class, okay? Just complete course book page number 48, 49, 50 and 51 in your course book, okay? Now, this is the end of our lecture. I hope you all have understood it very well.